Seorang Kristen yang mengerti tentang Bible-nya maka 100% akan berkata seperti mantan biarawati ini yang akhirnya memutuskan untuk menjadi ateis karena tidak percaya lagi terhadap kitab Bible-nya dan juga tidak percaya terhadap doktrin-doktrin Paulus dari Tarsus.
Paul essentially turned Jesus into a god, saying things like Christ, who is God over all, and our God and Savior, Jesus. But what did Jesus say? He said, why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. And many other statements like this. Catholic priests and nuns don't get married and they live a celibate lifestyle. But this isn't because Jesus said not to. It is because Paul said, I wish all were single just as I am.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, sahabat official. Apa kabarnya? Semoga senantiasa dalam lindungan Allah, dimudahkan segala urusannya, dimudahkan rezekinya. Dan alhamdulillah wa syukurillah kami di sini masih diberikan kesehatan dan kesempatan sehingga bisa kembali membersamai kalian untuk mengomentari video-video menarik, video-video unlogic ataupun video-video fenomenal yang ada di dunia kristologi. Kali ini kita akan mengomentari tentang bagaimana pendapat mantan biarawati ini dan semoga video yang kami buat ini bisa menjadi inspirasi serta menjadi jalan hidayah bagi siapapun yang menyimaknya. Langsung saja tanpa berlama-lama, mari kita saksikan bersama-sama kisah seorang biarawati yang kini justru malah menentang ajaran Kristen itu sendiri setelah dia tahu bahwasanya Paulus hanya seorang perusak dari ajaran Yesus.
Did you know if you remove the writings of Paul from Christianity, you would have a completely different religion? Christians today don't follow the Jewish laws, including what they eat or even following the Abrahamic commandment of circumcision. But why is that? Because Paul said things like, for sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace. And Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law. But what did Jesus say? He said, do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not an iota, not a dot will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever relaxes one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. Paul essentially turned Jesus into a god, saying things like, Christ, who is God over all, and our God and Savior, Jesus. But what did Jesus say? He said, why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. And many other statements like this. Catholic priests and nuns don't get married and they live a celibate lifestyle. But this isn't because Jesus said not to. It is because Paul said, I wish all were single just as I am. And he said that in order to prevent the desire to get married, it is good that a man should not touch a woman. Jesus, on the other hand, had only positive things to say about how marriage has been God's way since the beginning of time. He said, have you not read that from the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united with his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has put together, let no man separate. So Paul basically said that women should be quiet and invisible. He said the women are to stay silent in the churches. If they desire to learn anything, let them learn from their own husbands at home, for it is improper for a woman to speak in church. And he said, I do not allow a woman to teach or exercise authority over a man, but to remain quiet. Paul encouraged people to submit to the same people who killed Jesus. He said, let everyone be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God. Consequently, whoever rebels against the authority is rebelling against what God has instituted. But Jesus was a figure who came representing change and hope for a better future. He was meant to establish a kingdom of God with himself as the king. Would he have ever said that the Roman tyrants were the rulers that God wanted? The truth is, Paul never met Jesus. In fact, by his own admission, he used to persecute the early Christians. And then he ended up spreading quote-unquote Christianity with teachings that were often totally opposite of what Jesus taught. And yet, the Roman Catholic Church included so much of his writing in the Bible that by word count, he is the second most featured author in the New Testament and the fifth biggest author in the entire Bible. That is highly suspicious, and it makes me wonder, What more did they do to distort the religion of Jesus?
Perkataan dari biarawati yang sudah memutuskan untuk menjadi ateis ini benar sekali. Bahkan dia juga sepakat dengan umat Islam yang menyatakan bahwa Pauluslah perusak ajaran Yesus. Walaupun kami akui bahwa Paulus yang membuat ajaran seperti ini tetap ada sisi baik dan sisi buruknya. Sebagaimana umat Islam meskipun berada di dalam sebuah agama yang benar, akan tetapi belum tentu dia beriman dan taat kepada Allah. Begitu juga Paulus, orang yang taat terhadap hukum Taurat dan menyebarkan nama Allah kepada kaum paganis, akan tetapi tetap divonis oleh Allah sebagai penghuni neraka. Sekiranya Paulus melonggarkan hukum Taurat seperti kata biarawati yang satu ini.
But what did Jesus say? He said, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not an iota, not a dot will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever relaxes one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called the least in the kingdom of heaven."
Paulus akan menempati surga yang paling rendah. Jika di dalam Islam itu adalah surga tingkat ke-8 ya. Namun, apa yang membuat Paulus malah masuk neraka? Tentunya karena menyamakan Yesus dengan Tuhan. Atau kalau umat Kristen sekarang mengatakan bahwa Yesus adalah Allah. Perbuatan inilah yang pada akhirnya mengundang murka Allah, yang pada akhirnya tidak diampuni oleh Allah yang Maha Pencipta, karena bagaimanapun juga kita kiaskan kepada diriku dan diri kalian, jika hak kalian saya ambil, apakah kalian akan marah? Jika kalian marah, maka begitu pula dengan Allah yang Maha Esa. Haknya diambil oleh manusia, lalu manusia itu memberikan hak Allah kepada manusia yang lain yang bernama Yesus. Itulah ajaran Paulus. Hal inilah yang akhirnya membuat Paulus kekal di nerakanya Allah. Sekiranya Paulus tidak musyrik kepada Allah, mungkin Paulus akan dimaafkan dan masuk ke dalam surga meskipun itu adalah surga yang terendah. Nah, apa saja ajaran Yesus yang tidak boleh dihapus namun boleh dilanggar dan dapat dimaafkan sebagaimana halnya di dalam konsepsi Islam?
1. Yesus ajarkan dua kalimat syahadat di dalam Yohanes pasal 17 ayat 3. 2. Yesus menyuruh menyembah hanya kepada Allah. Dalam Matius pasal 4 ayat 10 tertulis. 3. Kewajiban melakukan sholat. Diatur dalam Keluaran pasal 40 ayat 31 sampai 32. Diwajibkan perempuan memakai jilbab. Diatur di dalam Korintus pasal 11 ayat 6. Haram makan babi. Imamat pasal 11 ayat 7 sampai 8. Haram minum minuman keras. Efesus pasal 5 ayat 18. Larangan membuat patung dan menyembah berhala. Keluaran pasal 20 ayat 4 sampai 5. Dan Ulangan pasal 4 ayat 23. Mengucapkan insya Allah atau apabila Allah menghendaki. Yakobus pasal 4 ayat 15.
Jadi kesamaannya, di dalam Islam segala dosa di dalam Islam dapat diampuni sekalipun melanggar 10 hukum atau melonggarkan hukum Taurat. Akan tetapi hanya satu yang tidak diampuni, yaitu meninggalkan atau meninggalkan, yaitu murtad sampai mati, lalu menyembah Tuhan selain Allah seperti orang Kristen dan para murtadin atau siapapun manusia yang mempersekutukan Allah. Maka jaminannya adalah kekal di nerakanya dan tentunya tidak ada ampunannya, termasuk umat Islam itu sendiri dan yang senasib dengan Paulus dari Tarsus apabila mereka menyekutukan Allah.
اللهم إني أسألك بأني أشهد أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت أنت الأحد الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.